I gotta show y'all this. I gotta show y'all this. Check out the new red skin for Viper. Color morphing skin. You unlock this in the Brocade treasure, and that's what we're here to talk about today. Is the Brocade treasure. We're gonna go over to the treasure pavilion and we're gonna take a peek at all the stuff that's inside right now. So let's dive right in. Welcome in. I hope your day's been good and it's about to get better. So let's peek in here and let's start off with this amazing Viper Ning skin that you have. Fades from red to white, white to red, however you want to say it. It looks amazing. Now you don't get the veil right here. This is actually just the outfit. The veil comes a little farther down here, the crimson veil. But we're going to move over to the second item, which is just as cool. This Akos skin is amazing. It looks really, really good. Especially out on the battlefield. It's bright, it's vibrant, it's dominating. This is an amazing skin. I mean, I think they did a really good job over here. You got the tiger head on the side. Wow. So let's talk about this, which is the Rebellion skin. What? Why does it look so good? Why does it look so good? It's doing stuff. That's a wicked skin right here for the pole sword. That's crazy. Yeah. Moving on next, we've got a cannon skin, which also looks amazing. The red theme here for a lot of the weapons and the skins is great. It's fine by me. This is the Divine Trial. For the cannon? That's gotta be the best cannon skin. That looks amazing. Moving on into the golds. Those are the four reds that we covered. This is the Street Carnival Graffiti outfit. It's sporty, yo. Yeah, that's wicked. I get behind that. Is this like a clear on the arm here? On the bottom side? Yeah. That's wicked. Okay. Moving on. That's for Faria, by the way. This is for Akos, another Akos skin. This one, if you're feeling like being a combatant, if you want to enter the ring, okay? If you're running V3 trying to enter the ring, then you have to have this in. This is your only outfit. I believe the headband comes a little bit later, so the headband's not going to be a guarantee if you pull this right here. Moving on to Tessa, you've got, what is this? The Frozen Sunshine? That's a wicked name. Really cool skin. I see the glimmer, like lights kind of caught inside the cosmetic, for sure. The back's real good, big bowy. That's awesome. And it's almost like a leaf itself, just like the material of it. Goes up the arms with more floral accents. That's pretty fire. Again, you have the Morning Dew Tessa exclusive. This is a... I believe it's a... Let's find out real quick. We're already here. Should be a gold. Well, we'll find out when we get there if this is a hairstyle or if this is just an accessory. I think it's a hairstyle, Morning Dew. So moving on, we are going to look at a Hottie Mini Wonders outfit. I actually like this outfit a lot, especially when you see it on the battlefield. This catches you like off guard. It stands out. It's really wicked, man. I mean, I think this is a cool outfit. Red, blue, those colors usually aren't used together often. And it's done in such a well way. It's almost like an orangish red, like maroon. Kind of avoided just blatant red a little bit. But it looks good, man. It's got leather in the cloth. I vibe with that. Plus the arm looks sick, right? That's one thing about Hottie. You get like really wicked arms. Moving over to the dagger. You guys know I'm a fan. The Manicore's Fang is here. This is wicked. It's got the little fiend, the little peacock head up top. I wanted to say like a phoenix, but it's like a peacock head, kind of like a bird head. We'll say that, right? And then you've got this curved blade, the blue into the purple. The purple fades up with the blue. The twist here with the... This is a wicked, wicked skin. Green's like my favorite color. So there's a bamboo version of this for the staff too. Like the beggar's staff, I believe. it's pretty cool. As soon as I saw this, I was like, yeah, you have to have it if you want to complete the set for sure. Determined, you've got tiger, white tiger themed nunchucks. Got the claws on the bottom, if you will, right? Fangs up top. Yo, this is pretty cool. Determined nunchucks. I like this a lot, actually. That's pretty nice. Moving on to the fan. Swoosh the feathers, baby. Fan blows the wind. The feathers, the gusts. Looks good. The frost theme is kind of cool, though. You've got these snowflakes that appear out of nowhere. Moving on to the bow of betrayal. Yeah, that's pretty cool, man. This reminds me... Oh, dude, I'll show you guys in Discord what this reminds me of for sure. This is wicked. Moving on to the red, pinkish, red, purple, vibrant, vermilion spite pistol skin. This is pretty wicked, man. I bet this looks good with certain outfits for sure. We got that veil that we talked about earlier seen on the skin in the beginning. It does change color. Starts off white, goes red along with the skin. Pretty crazy for Viper. Scorching Feather. This is a Tessa exclusive. This is an accessory that you throw on her hip. I mean, it's got gold tones to it. I'm sure you can find something that it looks really, really good with. Street Carnival. This is the Tiggy. Everybody meet Tiggy. Tiggy on the back. Tiggy's so cute when you attack. I like it. That's for Faria. Moving on, we have the headband that we saw earlier. So you can see it under here a little bit. It was on that orange outfit. I've got some accessories on mine. But yeah, you get that too. Fragrant basket. Little flowers inside a basket on the hip for Tessa. Citrine. What is this? Citrine monocle. Hottie exclusive. Yo, the band has like this braiding. This is pretty cool. I also like this, which is almost like a power level rating to me. That's pretty cool. I think you have like a small extra magnifying glass here, and then bam, the monocle itself sitting right there. It's got this circle in the front of it, which is pretty cool. Hottie's a cool character, man. I can't even deny. Moving on, we're still in the gold section, about to hit the purples. The underworld arch background. So we want to look at the background here where this purple, it's got, you know, a dojo that it's featuring in the background. That's pretty wicked. Dark Knight exclusive. This is not a background. This is the base. I like that background that I'm using for her right now. That's a wicked background. You can get those kind of things in the game different ways. This, though, is the Dark Knight base. It's got this tree that's crawling up with some purple ropes on it. Tessa, fan dance. This is a gesture. Go ahead. Go ahead, do the fan dance. That's a big fan, ladies and gentlemen. Yep. Fan dance. Wah, 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 wah. Wah. Okay, Tessa fan dance. Yes. All right, moving on to Division Robes Shale. Shale. Never heard that word, I don't think. Shale. Interesting color, too. Like, what would you even describe this as? Like, the bottom is almost purple, brown, like, you know, pink. I don't know what to say. The greaves, you know, are kind of pink. On the back here, though, this top portion, like this top little vest. I don't know what color that is. It looks really good. My hair for this character kind of matches what's going on here, so... I obviously like the color. We're moving on to Dahu. This is the Azure. This is for Akos. So it's like a purple, like a bluish purple outfit with a belt. The bracers and the back portion is pretty cool too. So moving on, we've got the Lethal Sapphire, Milady. Zai, already lethal, right? Coming in with a purple outfit all the way up to the neck, tapered up. It's got the, it's like a cape-ish skirt that it is. And it flows around when you're moving. It's cut into fours. Pretty cool. I like this outfit. We have this outfit. Big fan. Moving on, the Fairy Robe Crimson Mist. This is a Tessa exclusive. So this is a really cool outfit in my opinion. It's got the mixing of the colors split down the middle, maroon and like gray, red and whitish, right? Like I vibe with those colors a lot. Each tassel is independent with a shared design. That's wicked. You know what I mean? It's got a little belt section too. And the fluffy cluster is here. Brocade shirt, malachite, I believe is how you say it. The brocade shirt, because it's a brocade treasure, right? The coloration's cool, teal. You don't see that a lot. Kind of a simple arm design on the side here. The sleeve rolled up. I vibe with this. This is pretty good. Simple and clean, definitely. The belt with the chain, it's pretty cool. Moving on, Dead Raven Amethyst. I think we've seen a lot of Dead Raven bow skins, and this is a purple version of that. Pretty wicked. I never had a complaint about it. The quiver is kind of cool. Again, it's almost like simple and clean for this. It's got a little jewel on the side of the quiver. It's pretty cool. Moving on to pistol skin, sandy copper. It is a copper. So not quite a gold, almost like brass, copper. It's got this purple bottom, which is really good. And then a blue back, blue barrels. I like that. Vermilion glaze. This is a musket skin. We got that purple theme still staying true here. A little bit of a gold, orange, copper in the middle. So that's pretty cool. We have a repeater crossbow, the Dark Jade. We've seen those two tigers featured on many of the repeating crossbow skins. This is another version. I actually like it a lot, the way that the black blends in with the green to make up the entire tiger, leopard, animal. And also you have the teal on the sides of the bow, so it kind of comes off like that from the get-go. Pretty cool. Moving on, it is a canon skin, God's Laughter. We've seen God's Laughters before, but this is a red lacquer version. So again, if you've got this maroon or red like outfit in mind, you'll be able to match this skin with it probably pretty well. Boom. The backside looks like a vase, right? The whole thing's like this vase cannon. It's pretty cool. Studs on the front. I vibe with it. Moving on, we've got Fierceness Demonic Ying. This is a pole sword. Bright purple pole sword. Yo, for what the style is on this pole sword, I mean, it could be the best style for this pole sword. But you get what I'm saying? Like, this style here is seen with different colorations. This coloration on this style of pole sword is like icing on a cake. Do you see how purple that is? Woo! Moving on. Dawnbreaker Crag. Kind of the definition of like simple and true, right? This is clean. I like it. You don't got a lot of flashiness, flare getting in your way. You just got the handle, the hilt, the blade. You're ready to go. Swing, swing. Moving on. Bellstriker Steel. This is a purple toned staff. We've seen this design before, but not with this coloration. So if you're going for like a purple skin, this is going to fit in. It's going to match it, especially if you like staff a lot. Leaning Heaven Azure Sky. So this is, again, that azure is almost bluish with a tint of purple. The blade has a tint of like... I thought it did, right? Is it just reflecting? Great graphics in this game. But, yeah, the blade looks good. The hilt does have some of that same like dark purple where... Or the handle. Did I say hilt? The handle of the blade. Moving on. Scarlet Tempest. Same design. A new refresh remake on it. It's gray and red. You cannot beat those colors. Those are pretty sick. We're moving on. Boom. Gale Skies. The Hold. I think all the fans are interesting because the thing about the fan is it has such a surface, right? Like such a cool surface to create like an actual full design. These are really important because when it's closed, you're going to see like this point happening here. The bottom's wicked. Moving on to the Scorching Dash Triumph. So these are halberds. It's almost a copper with red ribbons on the bottom of the blades. Pretty sick. I mean, this design for the halberds is wicked. Classic. Moving on, Cloud Scroll. Cloud Scroll is an accessory here. We got to figure out exactly what we're looking at here. Okay, blue, white, pink on the bottom. I'm down with it. It's on the hip. Almost like a single chuck is what it looks like, right? Tri shot. Now this thing is an accessory. You see this from across the map. This thing is I guess like a pistol of some sort, right? You can't use it, it's an accessory, but tri shot meaning like it looks like it has a triple barrel. This is pretty cool. It's for UA Sean. That's who that is on his hip. We've got a Houdian. Houdian, this is an accessory for the hip. I like it. This is like a metal, right? Enameled metal. So lighter color blues and greens with a red gem in the middle. Some white there, gold all around. Like, this is really cool. I like this. I'd rock this for sure. Houdian. Houdian. Message in a... Yeah, message in a bottle is this right here. I actually like how clean it is, right? I like the top portion there. It's got a little bit of design on that marble. Silver with like brass. Yeah, that's pretty wicked. I like that too. Moving on to the bubbles. Akos, bring it on, bubble. Pop it up. Bring it on. I love the bubbles in this game. I'm sure everybody does. Throwing up a bubble in pregame or in mid-game is just super fun. Brings a lot of character to the game. Moving on next, we have another bubble, which is Tessa Laugh. So, lighthearted, in good spirits, a little laugh emote, Tessa. Faria, hey. She got her tongue stung out, little peace sign. She's rocking the mechanic headwear. I think it's a cool emote for sure. Definitely a lot of brown tones. It's a darker emote. This here, the Zai Disdain. Disdain, of course, Zai having such a tattered past. Never really smiles too much, but she's here. She's featured in a bubble, and her hair's all did up. So we're moving on to the Hottie Study. He's got a scroll. We see a lot of scrolls in this season. Boom. He's reading up. He's trying to figure out the recipes. Boom, boom, boom. His little eyes. It's cute. It's cute. Moving on, we got the forest. This is a background for Hottie. This is an exclusive background featuring like a luscious tree branch up top with some greenery. Greenery in the background. I like it. Let's see. A script form. So we've got this dull tones with like realism gray wood, right? So we've got the Hottie Study emote. He's studying one of those scrolls. His eyes are there focused in. He's got the feathered cap that he always has on in some of his, as an option for some of his cosmetics. You can put on that hat right there. And then he's studying the scroll up. Moving on, the forest background. We talked about being a branch with some greenery. You've got some more greenery here behind him. Forest background for Hottie exclusive. It's pretty cool. We've got the script form Faria Shin exclusive. This is a background with like duller tones, some real wood featured there with grain, maybe some yellow and stone. We're going to move on to another Faria Shin exclusive. This is the mortise. The base here is what you're looking at, what she's standing on. It's very flat, so it allows you to display a lot of the background. That's actually a pretty cool base. Fetters. This is another base. For Tessa, and it doesn't have a lot of background fill, so you get to see the background like really, really well. This is a cool base too. We're moving on. We got more bases. The Rough Terrace is what he's on. Hottie exclusive. This is a, I'm guessing like a perch he could just take off from on top of a high mountain. You know what I mean? Starting form, this is a Zai exclusive pose at the beginning of the match. You're going to see this displayed. I need this. This looks really cool. This is one of the best Zai poses that I've seen. You've got her chains featured in full glory here, stretched out, and even coming in like 3D towards the camera. This is really cool, man. Yo, I like that. Moving on, we've got more stuff inside this treasure here. The Brocade treasure just keeps giving. Endless Charms, a Tessa exclusive. It's a pose that you can have for her. She's holding, I believe, the dual blades here. Dual halberds, excuse me. And that's a wicked skin on the dual halberds. Flickering Flames. This is cool. When you get elimination, oh, look at that. It like swirls in, bursts out. It's got almost like wings there. That's wicked. That's cool. A very cool design. Ghostly Flame. I'm a big fan of the kill eliminations, so the more options, the better. The Ghostly Flame is something I'll definitely throw on from time to time. That it looks really, really good. Especially probably on like a TikTok video at the end or whatever. That's where you see those things kind of the most. This is the Deft Mechanic Brown version. We talked about a Deft version for her a little bit earlier. This is orange with brown. This is good for like a desert scene or whatever style you might have going on with her hair and whatnot. Shuhi Brown. I don't really see a lot of brown here, man. I'm not going to lie. It's, again, like that purple that we've seen featured a lot in the Brocade treasure. So this is more of like a purple Akos Who skin. I'm sorry. Akos Who skin. It's not bad, though. It's got some stitching on the side. You see some thread. Soft leather. Purple yet again. We love that color here in the Brocade treasure. Soft leather dusk. This is for Zai. A purple outfit. It's pretty good. It's almost like made out of leather again. Here we go. Leather. Shrewness. Copper. So Tessa gets a copper, right? A brown and beige outfit. Kind of keeping with the sandiness, maybe. That could be found in Hollowroth. Moving on. The Candy's Coat Blue. Another simple, clean. There's not a ton of like things happening on the outfit. And that's cool for a lot of people. It can help you stay focused. The arm looks really cool with this one, in my opinion. It's got almost like a shield of its own that's happening here. I like the outfit with the checker pattern on the bottom. Moving on, we see some weapons. We see the Doji Giri Yatsutsuna. Doji Giri Yatsutsuna Indigo. It's such a unique skin. I mean, this doesn't even look like a lot of things you see in here. It's to me, it's got this retro vibe. It's almost like game-based, right? Like, we're playing video games. We're out here having a good time. That's what this represents to me, so it's pretty cool. Moving on, we do have the Stone Hewer Suffering. So, kind of green, kind of copper. That, you know, that tone that keeps popping up again and again. And it is a Pole Sword skin. Next, the Ancestral Boon Onyx. This is the Hang Sword, so... If you don't already have a bunch of Hang Sword skins, the newest weapon that's been released in Naraka, you can come over to the Brocade treasure and potentially pull you another one. This is a brown one. If you've got some of these outfits too, you're going to want this. You're going to want it to match up. It looks good. I like the handle too. Stormcaller Umbra Branch. So this is a staff skin, and this is a brown skin with some black wrapping. Very, very clean. Hydrilla. The Hydrilla. It's green. Y'all know that's like one of my favorite colors. Kind of has this yellowish tint to it in, or almost, you know, metallic tint to it in the middle there on the hilt. Leaf patterns up top. And you've got a green handle on the blade. Blue Fleeting Sky Nunchuck skin. This is good. You don't see this color a lot. And they have it available on the nunchucks now. Same thing, close to the same color. The Winter Bloom Orchid. It's a fan skin. It's got these little flame poofs up top. And in the very middle is a diamond made of, looks like copper, gold. Keen Edge. Keen Edge is a series of daggers that's been around for a while. There's a lot of them. This is the Brown Crag. The Brown Crag looks good. The handle's got a little bit of work in it. You can see some material almost like marble there, like a wood, like a hardwood. Boom. Keen Edge. Big fan of the Edge series for sure. Line Breaker Injury. White skin, crescent style blades. Yeah, the halberds are going crazy right now. This looks really good. I like this, especially fighting against it. It'd be looking really good. Moving on, Narcissus. This is a bow skin. So I think the hilt here, or I'm sorry, the quiver, is like one of the best parts of this. You've got the white on blue, gray on blue, very light color on the blue. But on the hilt, you've got more of like detail with the stripes. You've got a little pocket. This is cool. And the bow, the feathers of the bows are blue, or the arrows. Storm Shatter, teal-ish blue, shiny pistol. I mean, the bottom's that brown, almost made out of wood, could be like a copper, boom. You've got the classic little spinnies over here on the handle. We've seen this before. Some red featured there. A cloud at the bottom. Boom, that pistol skin looks good. Storm Shatterer. Belladonna Emerald Plume. On the bottom here, this plume is really cool. It's an emerald plume, and I like how it detaches from the gun a bit, kind of bursts away on its own, comes back. It flows really good. The back here, this would look cool when you're firing, when you're holding it, you know, in game. I think those would look really good. I also like this jeweled section that's here on the hilt. It's like a random blue color right in the middle of white and beige. Like, it looks really good. So this is a cool musket skin. Repeater crossbow. It's pink. It's a pink repeater, yo. Red clouds on the back. Golden handle, right? This is pretty cool. Yeah, this is clean. I would rock it. I'd rock it 100%. I like the metal vibes to it, too. Moving on, we've got a cannon. Cruel wood. The cruel wood is this same kind of color we've been seeing. It's like copper. It's like brass. It's metallic, right? It's more dull, but it's also shiny. It's pretty cool. We have an ocarina for Akos. You can't see it as well. My skin's going to cover it up a little bit, so I'm super sorry. But it is this little bird here. Boom. We can move over and check it out maybe at the end if we remember to check out the ocarina. But it's a bird, a carved wood bird. You see its wing adorned there and its little pointy head. Ink Flask Fairy Shin exclusive. This is wicked. This just like sits right on the hip. It's subtle. It doesn't take up a lot of room on the rest of the outfit. Yeah, it's pretty cool. Brown bag. I vibe with it. Pin Set Pocket Watch. This is one I'm using right now. This is a red pocket watch. We saw one that kind of looked like this earlier on his right hip for Hottie. So a metal pocket watch. Incomplete. Tessa gets another hip replacement. Incomplete. Tessa gets another hip accessory here. Incomplete. This is a Tessa exclusive. It goes on the hip. It's kind of simple. It's almost that same wood. Is it wood? Is it metal? Is it copper? We don't know. It's brown. It's got a little yin and yang up top. Pretty cool. We're moving on to Radiant. This is a background. This background is bright. It's vibrant. It's pretty wicked. I think you could pair it with some really cool bases and some really cool outfits and make this thing pop. Moving on to another background. This is for Akos. It's got the browns. It's got the, you know, the tones that we've been seeing this entire time with that blue gray there too. That's pretty wicked. Ruby parasols. So it's like umbrellas stacked on top of each other. It seems to be like a curtain coming down. I kind of like it. You know what I mean? It's red, it's vibrant, it's bright. This is the mountainous. This is the mountainous Tessa exclusive background. Kind of cool. It's almost like hand-drawn or like pastel. Like, I think those are really cool. There's a couple of those that are in the game, and all of them look really wicked. It's like, it's just unique artwork. And so you have that in the background if you want to start a match with that. Getting towards the end here, we see the cogwheel base for Fairy Shin. It's a cogwheel. It's got some ropes tied around it with some wooden pins, pegs. It doesn't take up a lot of background, so I think it's actually pretty cool. Tonbok, this is a Hottie exclusive. Again, a very low profile pedestal. We're seeing a lot of low profile pedestals here, and that allows you to look at the background artwork a lot more too. The opera drum for the opera drum, the masks on the bottom of it, very, very alluring, interesting, right? I think this is one of the best bases that you're going to see in this treasure for sure. Final Judgment from Zai. This is another base that you can stand on. Very low profile. You're going to show a lot of background. Almost looks like a jar or pot of some sort. The Spectral. Tessa exclusive. Boom. Flat. Clean. Love it. Got a couple cloud designs on it etched into the metal. Bruh. More bubbles that you can throw out on the battlefield. Bro. Bro. This man's eating candy, chilling with sunglasses on, vibing. The ingot? I like this one. It's just like a golden froggy. I don't even know what he wants to say, but he wants to say something, right? Moving on, we've got the heal up. That's why you're taking your healing berries. You're eating them. You're chugging some armor as well. You know what I mean? You need to heal up. That's actually an emote you could throw out to your teammates to suddenly kind of remind them, hey, don't forget to top off your heals. Maybe this one as well. Here, take healing berries if you're dropping something for a teammate, right? Maybe you want to use it in battle. Who knows? Here's armor powder. Here's armor powder. Here's healing berries. Yo, here's armor powder. Is amazing. That's so cool. They got the armor powder spilled out. And then last but not least, here's a gold weapon. So some of these could be used, again, to communicate to your team. And some of these could be used, I don't know, mid-fight to just have fun. Yo, chat, you need to get on here and get you some Brocade treasures. They have so much cool stuff that are here that's featured that we've been checking out. I appreciate you guys always coming through and watching the videos. Any feedback, anything that you have, leave it in the comments for me, man. As well as I've got more informative videos and also some cool gameplay videos coming too. So see you guys later. We've got an update coming. Get on, get ready. More cool stuff all the time. I'll keep you covered and updated. Bye. Peace.